Geek and repair enthusiasts, welcome to another tech episode from TechTap. In this episode, we will show you on how to fully disassemble the 2021 model 14-inch MacBook Pro with M1 Pro processor. Let's begin the teardown. Make sure to have your tool set ready and safety glasses on. And if you don't have one, make sure to visit techtap.com and you will find all the tools and parts you may need for your tech projects. Now make sure laptop is fully off and remove the 8 P5 screws from the back. Using a suction cup, pull the back case upward about 2 inches until you hear 2 snapping sounds, indicating you can now pull the back case toward yourself in order to fully release it from the main chassis. Holding mechanism on these back case are similar to all models from 2016 till today. Now, in order to disconnect the power, you would need to disconnect and remove the trackpad flex cable from the logic board by removing the 2 T4 screws that holding the trackpad flex cable bracket into the logic board, and using your pry tool, disconnect the cable. Next, using your pry tool, remove the battery to logic board flex cable. Using the tip of your pry tool, unlock the 2 small mechanisms that hold the cable and slowly remove it. Be very careful around this cable, as it's very easy to break. Now that you can access the direct battery to logic board connection, using your T5 screwdriver, remove the 1 screw that is holding the connection, and using your pry tool, pull the connection away from the battery. Now remove the 10 T5 screws that hold the trackpad into the chassis in order to have access to start removing the battery at adhesive tabs. Crack open the laptop in order to remove the trackpad. Using your pry tool, unlock the trackpad flex cable locking mechanism and flatly pull the flex cable out. If you are just replacing the battery in your laptop, then you do not need to remove the cable and proceed to the battery removal. In order to remove the battery, first we need to pull the 8 adhesive tabs from the edges of the battery. Using your pry tool, dig for the tabs and then pull them out slowly. In my experience, this was not a smooth experience, as they all break halfway. And that lead me on digging back again for the same tabs and trying to remove the rest. This was a little bit frustrating, but with some patience, then you should be fine. This was the final effort on behalf of Apple to make battery replacement easier, but not sure if they succeed or if they really meant it to make it easier. Why not just secure the battery to the chassis using few normal screws like every other brand? Not sure why. Maybe you tell me why in the comment section below. One thing I wanted to mention, that when you are working around battery, make sure to be very cautious. Do not poke the battery and do not bring sharp object or tools near the battery. You must understand the risk. Plus, make sure to wear a safety glasses to protect your eyes from possible accident. Please note, this is a tutorial mainly for entertainment purposes. If you are planning to perform any repair, make sure you do enough research and you understand your risk and your skills, or else just let a professional handle the work and you sit back, relax, and still enjoy this video. Now it's time to flip the laptop open in order to access and remove the 6 other adhesive tabs located within the trackpad area that holding the battery to the chassis. After digging for the tape using my pry tool in order to make pulling the battery tape easier, I am using my tweezer to wrap around and then pull outward. But I'm absolutely making sure that my tweezer is not going to make any contact with the battery. So if you've never done this before, I strongly recommend you staying away from using metal tweezer and instead wrap around your plastic pry tool. Just to make sure there will be no damage to the battery that can even cause fire or injury. It's worthy to mention, here at techtap.com, we are specialized in offering all parts, including batteries, and repair tools for all models and brands. TechDep is based in the United States and offers quick shipping globally to your doorstep. Alright, now that all the battery glues are removed, it is time to remove the one T5 screw that holds the battery board to the chassis, and then you may fully remove the battery and lift it. Let's start disconnecting the cables from the logic board to prepare the logic board for final removal. Start with the keyboard flex cable mechanism. Unlock it and pull it out using your pry tool. Now unlocking and removing the keyboard backlight cable. Remove the left speaker flex cable and continue removing rest of the flex cables. Removing the microphone flex cable. Removing the right speaker flex cable. Just a quick note, I'm not really removing the cables in a specific order, so feel free to remove the cables on order you like. Main goal is to get all the cables disconnected and out of the way. I'll continue by disconnecting both fan flex cables. Using T4 screwdriver, removing two screws that are holding the headphone jack cable bracket, and using pry tool, I'll disconnect the cable. If you ever need to change this board, you can easily replace it as it's easily accessible. Continue using T4 screwdriver to remove screws that holding the bracket above the two independent USB-C boards and disconnect using the tip of the pry tool. Using T4 screwdriver, we'll remove the MagSafe bracket and disconnect the flex cable. Continue using T4 screwdriver. We'll remove the display sleep mode sensor cable bracket and disconnect the flex cable using the tip of the pry tool. Keep using the T4 screwdriver and remove the two screws per each bracket that hold the LCD flex cable and disconnect each using your pry tool. Using T4, remove the two screws that hold the Touch ID bracket and using the flat side of your pry tool, slowly separate the cable from the logic board, then disconnect the cable. Be very careful. Now remove the two T4 screws to disconnect the right side USB-C port. Using T4, remove two screws that hold the Wi-Fi antenna cable bracket and one that hold all the cable to the logic board, and using pry tool tip, disconnect the three cables from the logic board. Using your tweezer, remove four plastic screw cover and continue removing 11 T5 screws that holds the logic board and both fan to the chassis of this MacBook Pro. Note that there is more screws holding the fans that needs to be removed once the logic board is out of the way. And now continue removing the T6 screws from the logic board. Finally, it's time to remove the logic board. Make sure all screws and cables are removed and out of the way. Using your pry tool, start separating the board slowly and without bending it. Note, if the board is not willing to come out easily, then it's a good possibility that something is still on the way or holding it. Continue the disassembly by removing the final four T3 screws that hold each fan. It's time to remove both fans out of the way. But too bad, in order to clean these fans, you need to remove the entire logic board, unless you use compressed air can. Remove the two final screws that hold the audio jack into the chassis. Continue using T5 tip and remove two screws per each USB-C board. Good thing these boards are easily replaceable if you ever need to. Four more screws are holding the MagSafe. Remove the two T5 and follow by removing the other two special looking T3 screws. Removing four T5 screws from the Wi-Fi antenna module. taking last USB-C out by removing two T5 screws. Remove the two LCD hinge cover screws using your T5 to prepare for display removal, and continue removing the T5 screws that sits on both ends of the Wi-Fi module. And continue removing the 9 T2 screws to allow for final removal of the antenna module. It's time to take the Wi-Fi module out of the way and take a look at the design. Using your tweezer, get both hinge covers out of the way. To remove both speakers, flatly slide your metal pry tool in between the speaker and the chassis of the MacBook Pro. Speakers are attached using a special type of glue, so you may need to use some extra strength, but be careful not to break the speakers. If you need any parts or tools used in this video, or looking for a Mac part, you can find all links in the description of this video. And now, in order to remove the entire display from the chassis, all we need to do is to remove 6 T9 screws that definitely take some muscle power. These screws are the responsible one to hold your display to the chassis. Time to disattach the display from the chassis, or so-called the top case. Open the LCD and let it sit in a 45 degree angle, and then give some downforce push. You see the display completely comes off. Now, to remove the Touch ID power button bracket, remove 5 T3 screws and continue removing 2 more T3 screws that holds the spring bracket, and remove using your tweezer. Finally, remove the one last T3 screw and remove the main back bracket. You can now freely remove the Touch ID power button. This teardown actually took about 1 hour to complete. This concludes our disassembly of 14-inch 2021 MacBook Pro. We hope you guys enjoyed and learned something from this video. And if so, please consider subscribing to TechDev channel and liking our video. See you guys on the next one.